The Karnak Temple Complex, commonly known as Karnak, from Arabic Kurnak, meaning fortified village, comprises a vast mix of decayed temples, chapels, pylons, and other buildings near Luxor in Egypt. The complex is a vast open site and includes the Karnak Open Air Museum. It is believed to be the second most visited historical site in Egypt. Only the Giza pyramids near Cairo receive more visits. It is consists of four main parts, of which only the largest is currently open to the general public. The key difference between Karnak and most of the other temples and sites in Egypt is the length of the time over which is developed and used. Construction of temples started in the Middle Kingdom and continued in Ptolemaic times. Approximately 3rd pharaoh contributed to the buildings, enabling it to reach a size, complexity and diversity not seen elsewhere. Few of the individual features of Karnak are unique, but the size and number of features are overwhelming. The deities represented range from some of the earliest worshipped to those worshipped much later in the history of ancient Egyptian culture. One famous aspect of Karnak is the hypostyle hall of the precinct of Amon Ra, a whole area of 50,000 square feet, which is 134 massive columns arranged in 16 rows. 122 of these columns are 10 meters tall, and the other 12 are 21 meters tall, with a diameter of over 3 meters. The architraves of the top of these columns are estimated to weigh 70 tons. These architraves may have been lifted to these heights using levers. This would be an extremely time-consuming process and also would require great balance to get to such great heights. A common alternative theory regarding how they were moved is that large ramps were constructed of sand, mud, bricks, or stone, and that the stones were then towed up to the ramps. If stones had been used for the ramps, they would have been able to use much less material. The Karnak Temple is a massive temple complex to which dozens of pharaohs added their own constructions. The area was a constant development and use between the Middle Kingdom and early Christian period. The immense size of the complex, as well as its various architectural, artistic, and linguistic details, make it an invaluable historical site and resource for understanding the evolution of ancient Egypt. And thus, its conservation is critical. Because of its long history of construction and functionality, the gods worshipped at Karnak range from some of the earliest Egyptian deities to some of the latest, thus offering an impressive presentation of ancient Egyptian religious practices and beliefs.